Well, I wasn't expected to already make a video like 10 minutes after the other one. But we have another system, so it's getting active again. We now have this system, which I was predicting. I don't know if you guys remember. In my previous video, I was saying this area had a 20% chance of developing. And here it is. So it's only 10% for some reason. It's not rendering out for the 5. Oh, there we go. So that's our system here, 10% chance. And National Hurricane is saying that slow development of the system is possible as it moves in the Caribbean before the conditions get unfavorable in the Caribbeans right now. So look, this is what we've got going on. So this, for some reason, is still 10% chance, even though it's now a invest. But it's still expected to move and make that landfall in North Carolina. Current winds of 30 knots, believe it or not. It's actually tropical depression winds already. But they're saying it's non-tropical. But this is Invest 94L nonetheless. So that's Invest 94L. Right here, this is an invest, but this also has 10%. Look, National Hurricane Center is saying that some slow development of the system is possible over the next couple of days before upper level winds become. So before basically it's possible that this will form before that upper level winds are very unfavorable at the moment in the Caribbeans right here. But so that's why this will not form too much and won't really intensify that much, because if we go to Mike's weather page, you'll be able to see. So that's Invest 94L right here. Again, that's our second system here. But if you do go to that shear map, again, those two systems are located in very unfavorable shear. So this is the first system right here in that 25 knot shear. That's the first low. And the second low is around here. It's in like 15 shear right now. That's why they're saying it could develop. But then it's just not going to be favorable anymore as it moves into this entire area. It's just very unfavorable for any development. Which is why they're not expecting any development. Like, look at this. 30 knots, 40 knots now. It's still like systems can form in those areas. But it's still not too favorable. And we're not going to be seeing. I think this could be a tropical storm and then just weaken to tropical depression as it moves in the Caribbean. But that's just going to be, we're just going to have to see how that does happen. Let's see if we do have, we don't have Invest 95L. But I'm going to be focusing on this. So look at the satellite imagery for both systems here. Let's look at Atlantic wide. So here are both our systems here. We'll just go right now. So that's the first one. This right here, looking better organized. This is the first one up here with that low round here. That's that center of circulation. So that's the first one. And the second one is this blob of disorganized showers, which is going to be moving into the Caribbean. We also have this tropical wave right here, which is going to be coming. That could also be a second possible system for tropical development. Now, do keep in mind, we do have drier coming all the way into, almost into that Caribbean. If we go to forecast models, you're going to be able to see that drier coming very far away. Now, that's that system. Again, GFS doesn't show it form. Not a lot of, it does show it briefly form in 18 hours. So we're just going to have to see if that does end up happening. But if we do go to, where is it? If we do go, so wind shear, first of all, again, look how unfavorable that wind shear is. Very unfavorable wind shear. Now, it's going to get more favorable, don't get me wrong, but at the moment, as we speak right now, it's in not very favorable wind shear. That wind shear is going to get a little bit more favorable in July, maybe. Even then, it just look at that. It's not just very high wind shear for ages, according to the GFS. Look at that wind shear everywhere in the Atlantic. When does that wind shear stop? Never. So it's just gonna be not very favorable for the time being right now. But yeah, I don't have a lot much to say else than that. I just wanted to show that brand new disturbance right here. So we're just gonna have to see. If I were to draw a cone for both of those systems, here they would be. Wait. Oh, and we also, yeah, we don't. I do think we also have a system here. Yep, 20% chance as well. But again, if I were to draw a cone for both of those systems, here it is. I do like to do this on the channel. Here's that first cone. That's the first cone. And that would be the second cone for both of those systems. That one would probably more going like straight north, kind of like this. And that second one would be somewhat like this. So those are the two systems. I do expect this one to, I was expecting this one to become a, to pull a Bertha, you know, national hurricane center didn't expect it to form, and at the last minute, it just became a tropical storm. So I can't expect that one to pull something like this, possibly. And this system down here could, I'm not ruling out a possibility for a Edward or Dolly. This could be Dolly up there moving into the air, and this could be Edward moving into the Caribbean. We're not ruling out those two possibilities. And we also have that second tropical wave, which could be whatever comes after Dolly and Edward.